Oh, whoa. What's this one? Oh, five. I've noticed now that there's a 580. So I don't care. Howdy, folks, and welcome back to Ark Extinction Adventures. You know, a couple things. One, we tamed Bam. Named him Bam. Last episode, Bam. And I've got him up to max level, level 723. We just did a server restart, and the melee damage did not seem to roll, thankfully. We will double-check that here in a moment, because he's doing some really good damage. Let's fall down into the water here. You might ask why he's green. Well, because I killed a whole bunch of stuff, including a couple of tribal chiefs, and more importantly, many of the scions, including the jungle scion, and he's wearing the costume of the jungle Megapithecus. So he looks like he's got green leaves everywhere. Let's just double check his damage, because I did have to restart the server just before I started recording for an update to Ark and a mod. Builder's helmet. Yeah, we still got the good damage. Cool. I didn't overload the damage spec. We are maxed out 603,000 health, which is just awesome. Almost 10,000 melee damage, as you could see what the damage was on that Pteranodon. 150 movement speed, which is awesome. Right? It also turns out that these guys do not harvest meat, as you saw. Let me kill this trike, and I'll show you. Just one hit, boom, he's dead, and his body just evaporates. They do not harvest meat. They do not actually eat meat. They eat baby food. Now, they'll eat carnivore or herbivore baby food, which is really interesting. If I force feed him one or the other, you'll see that right now he's down there, and if I force feed him that, he goes back up. Now, he actually, I'm pretty sure, will eat this on his own when he gets his food down to a really low level. Not to a normal eating level for most things, but it's like if he's like 1,000 down or something, he'll eat one. Because I had left some in there. Now, it might have expired, now that I think about it. So, never mind. I was thinking that the count went down, and it might have been because he ate it, or it might have been because it expired. I don't know. I've also heard tale, T-A-L-E, tale, that they will eat prime meat. And that's interesting. I don't know. We will find out. At least some of these bosses will eat prime meat. Maybe an herbivore, like a Megapithecus, won't, though. So his food is down just a little bit. Let's do a force. Oh, yeah. 8-4. I got him maxed out by forcing that, so he'll eat that as well. So we're going to take that out, actually, since it's a little rarer. I'd either have to make it or I'd have to find it by killing important things. And we'll put that back in the refrigerator. We'll just use prime meat. We'll put another stack of prime meat on him. One thing I want to do is I want to go out and hunt with him and show you guys the power of the BAM. But I would also like to... Oh, it's not over here. It's over here. I've got a new piece or a couple pieces of this armor. This prime armor. And there's a piece I really want to make. See if I can make it. The prime is down here. And it's either the... Oh, it's this helmet right here. That's a 230 armor. Yeah. Well, either one. I think we can make this one. The flak one. Not a problem. Although I do wear the builder's helmet, as you know. But there's that. But what I really, 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 really want to make is... Where is it? I swear I had it. I know I had it. It was a chest piece. Maybe I've still got it on an animal. But some of these things require a lot of prime blood. And we're a little short on prime blood. Actually, it might be in here. It might be in here because I was going to make it. Not that. Did I put it down here? There it is. The riot chest piece is what I really want to make. 700 prime blood. I've only got 238. We're going to go farming prime blood. Here you can see, by the way, some more things down here. The evidence that I killed some things with. Bam. We've got a Dodorex essence. I just went up and bashed on a Dodorex for a while and killed it. So that's pretty cool. And we've got more Megapithecuses in there. We don't have any dragons yet. We don't have a broodmother. One thing I would like to do with you guys is kill a broodmother. I have not done that yet. So, we need to find out what has that prime blood, kill a bunch of it, and collect its bits. Okay? Okay, let's start out here with a level 40 Megapithecus. First of all, let's launch a rock into this group here. And see what kind of damage the rock does. It does a lot. Look at that. Oh, even against the Megapithecus, 100 and some odd. Go ahead and beat him up. Beat up his little minions. Should be able to kill him fairly quickly. There we go. He's gone. Now it's a matter of getting his minions. by. Let's take them one at a time with rocks. Aw, oh, missed. Boom. Kill you. Knock you back. The spin is so nice. Just knocks things back. These guys have so much health, these minions. I just don't understand. I could just run away and let them despawn, but they have so much health. They do a fair amount of damage, too. I mean, it's nothing to sneeze at with this saddle. 300 damage is pretty good. There we go. They're level 1200. That guy's still fighting something. There we go. Wow. Okay, did he drop a bag at all? Because as you notice, if I don't pick it up, let's come down here and see. No. Okay, here we go. This is from the Megapithecus. There he is. Essence. If I get the essence, then I got... You're trying to jump up here and take me? No way, man. If I got the essence, I got everything else. So that's pretty cool. But no blood. So we're still looking at what's got the blood. All right, here's a scion down here. There's something over there. Is that just a regular old wyvern? What is that? Come down here and take a look. Or is that a skeletal wyvern? It's a regular old wyvern. They're easy enough to kill. They're not a problem. As you see, that was pretty low level. Usually they take a couple of hits. Oh, picking on a penguin. That's what you were doing. Oh, looks like we got some villagers, some tribe. There's a guy right there. All right, Cyan tribesman gone. Let's make sure all the tribesmen are gone before I take on this scion. I wanted to show you guys this scion and how it's not that hard to take them on when you have something that can just take a lot of damage and give a lot of damage. Like, you notice he's doing about 378 to 864. He's not doing a lot, and we're doing tons. He's not doing any debuffs, so we don't have to worry about anything. This is just a matter of pounding on him till he dies, basically. And just watching your health, but he's not doing enough damage to really worry about it. And there he goes, Scion of Winter defeated. I picked up all his stuff, and he drops some pretty cool stuff, usually some skins. He'll drop that. Here's a skin. What is it? A Morellatops snow skin. That's a new one. I haven't had that one yet. So, pretty cool. Okay, we have an opportunity to fight a manticore. Can't really tame one yet, but I have to kill one in order to tame one, right? 420. Ooh, that's going to be a fight. Let's see if we can do it. Ooh, wow. Already. Never mind. That may not have been one of the... since there was no special text on that one, might not have been one of the extinction manticores. I don't know of a way to test that. I mean, I do if I had paid attention. And if you guys just scroll back a little bit in the video, you can see how much torpor it had. If it had 10 million, it's an extinction manticore. Something tells me it's probably a desert scorched earth manticore. So, do we get anything from it? Manticore flags? And so we did get something from it. This is definitely new since the last time I checked my inventory. Although that might have come from the villagers or villagers tribesmen I just killed. So, anything over here? There we go, manticore trophy. Yeah, so we did get the stuff that's on it, so we don't need to do anything more. Now, it's interesting. Can I make this thing go away? Nope. Those manticore bodies just will not be harvested, no matter what. They won't even be disintegrated. Okay, so we've got a prime dung beetle. Let's see what we can do to it. Oh, we killed it right away. Any blood? No blood. Any bag? No bag. I want a Dodo. Dodorex. Dodorexy. What level is that Dodorexy? It's a level 500. Very tameable, but I don't think... No, I've killed some. I have essences. There's a tribesman right there. Let's go ahead and get it. There we go. Get rid of that purple tribesman. I think I'll leave that Dodorexy. Another tribesman? Looks like it is. Yep. We'll leave this one for somebody else who may want to tame it. Wandering through the jungle there. Wandering through the swamp. I'm back at base to drop some stuff off, and I noticed something else. He may fill up his food with prime meat, but it's like spoiled meat for a human. Watch his health. His health is diminishing as I feed him prime meat. So, goodbye, prime meat. Let's get back to the food. This guy, carnivore baby food. We'll use that instead. That should improve his health. I mean, his health regenerated automatically, but this is a preferred food. I guess you could feed him prime because the extinction creatures regain health over time automatically, pretty quickly. So you could theoretically feed him prime if he had nothing else to get his food up. But for now, I think I'll just leave the carnivore baby food in there. Anyway, I got to drop off some stuff, and then we'll go search for some more possible sources of prime blood. Okay, so check in with the developer. Ooh, I like it in the dark like this. The prime blood comes from the strongest alphas. So like alpha brontos and rexes and things like that. Big, like behemoth alphas. So that's what we need to look for. That's what we're going to get. Okay, it's not an alpha bronto, and there's tribe members here, but there's a skeletal bronto, an ancient bronto. I wonder if it'll have it. He did say alphas. He specifically said that, so I'm guessing no. But, you know, let's find out. Oh, yeah. Got his attention now, didn't I? Here he comes. Come on. Come on, buddy. What are you spawning as your minions? Kill this guy. See if he can give us some blood. Something tells me no. Like I said. Oh, there's a wyvern over there. Oh, he spawns Zomdodos. Okay. I see no blood. Figured as much. Gotta get rid of these Zomdodos first. Okay. yep, no blood. But a Bronto skeletal costume. Okay, you've seen me fight the Scorched Earth ones. This is 10,000 or 10 million Torpor something here biting me. So let's fight them. This is one of the Extinction Manticores. He's got Vulture Helpers, which are nasty because they can attack me. I don't like that. No debuffs going. And he's doing a fair amount of damage. We killed him. Okay, the vultures are still... They fortunately are not going after me. They appear to be going after him. My mount, which is good. Oh, I killed an orange tribesman here? Ugh. Not really in the mood for fighting tribesmen at the moment. They're not giving me anything that I want. There he is behind us, so we're just going to leave. I can fight tribesmen any day. I'm just looking for the big alphas, and I'm not having much luck. Kind of been all over the map, and I haven't found one yet. Very frustrating. Okay, we are back. We haven't found any prime blood yet, but we did find something for Chicken Little. And by the way, looks like Scriptar found a skin for the vulture and left it in here, which is really cool. I'll put it up here so you can see it. It makes the vulture all white and shiny. Don't really like that, though. It's a little too bright. But I found this one, which I'm really excited about. I don't know what it's going to look like. Fire vulture, let's see. Oh my god, yes. Oh, that is perfect. Chicken Little, you never looked more ferocious. That is awesome. Okay, Broodmother, level 340. It's your turn. We were going to leave this one here to tame, but I have a feeling we're going to do a Destroy Wild Dinos before anybody can tame it, and I've noticed that there's... Oh, whoa. What's this one? Oh, I've noticed now that there's a 580. So I don't care. We will attack this one and leave the 580 for somebody to tame. I sure hope we can take it. I think we can. I've got the detoxes ready to go. I might need them. Here we go. Watch the torpor. Damage isn't that bad. Watch the torpor. Okay, torpor starting. Killing the minions. Looking at that torpor. If it starts getting up there, we're out. Oh, got it. Woo! Spinny. There we go. Something's still hitting me? Oh, yeah. Something's still hitting me. What did I get from that? Obviously, the Broodmother Essence. Some more of those blueprints. And then the trophy. Okay, pretty cool. No blood, though. Still looking for the big alphas. You'll need to find a Rex or a Bronto or something. Having no luck. All right, after searching for a very long time, I have found an Alpha Bronto that is after me because I ran up to it. I wanted to get it on film for you guys. Get on film. I'm old-fashioned. I wanted to capture it on video for you guys. Will he have the blood? No. He had nothing? Oh, sigh. This is going to take forever. Oh, man. And what is this but another one? Let's see if this one gives us something. Come on. Fight back. Oh, there it goes. All right. Blood? Blood? He gave us stuff. Did he give us any blood? Nope. No blood. Sigh. All right. I'm fed up. I give up. We're gonna call the hunt. It's been about three total days of trying to find Prime Blood and finding zero. I found a ton. Well, I found a ton. I found a bunch. The first couple of days we played on this server, as you can see, there's some Prime Blood there. 238. I think I have a little bit more. No, that's all I have. Huh? Weird. I thought I had. I know I had more. Does this stuff expire? Huh? I had about 1,000. Very strange. Did I use it? Or did somebody borrow it? I don't know. I had a bunch. It's no longer here. But I'm not having any luck finding any more. So, instead, what we're going to do is, first of all, we're going to see what kind of armor we can make. What our best of this prime armor is that we can make. Actually, I want to go ahead and put that scuba tank back in there because I'll make that some other time. Because that's an unbreakable scuba tank, which should mean it's a scuba tank that'll last forever. And I'll never run out of air, right? Theoretically, because that's how you tell how much air it has, what its durability is. And when it breaks, it's out of air, right? So, okay, we're gonna take all these prime blueprints. I've tried to make sure I only have one of each type, although now I realize I have a tank over there and a tank here, so I can drop that. And let's go ahead and sort this alphabetically and see if we have any dupes in here. Looks like we do not have any dupes. Okay, so best armor that we can make without Prime Blood. We can't make the Riot stuff without Prime Blood. Although it says 250 for that. How much Prime Blood did I say I had? I've been left with 238. I say that because I counted the other day when Scriptar was asking, and I knew I had close to 1,000. So something happened. Not pointing fingers anywhere. All right, let's go back here to the good stuff. I can't make that. It takes 500. I cannot make, where did they go? Well, I'm not sorting alphabetically anymore. There we go. Can't make these, just barely can't make these. That's awesome. Definitely can't make that. Takes 700. So it looks like flak, although I don't want a helmet because I've got my builder's helmet. So what's the best chest piece I've got? Right now I've got an armor 80 chest piece. Let's look at the chest pieces. That's going to be an armor 40. No good. That's going to be an armor 80. Same as what I've got. Armor 80. Same as what I've got. Armor 100. Okay, so I can definitely take the chitin chest piece. The leggings are already chitin. That's going to be the best thing I have, I think. The boots are already chitin, and the arms, the hands, I can take the chitin as well. So I think I have everything I need to make these. So let's go ahead and put back the boots and the legs and everything else. Yeah, everything else. And then we're going to go ahead and make this stuff at least so that we'll have something better than what we had before. Let's go ahead and put these over here. And in order to make those, I'm going to need just a chitin chest piece and chitin gauntlets. And I think I probably have some of those in my armor storage. Gauntlets, let's take the worst one, 339. I shouldn't have dragged it. And chest piece, 275. Let's just grab those. Doesn't matter what quality they are, it'll work. So we're going to put those over here. Scroll to the bottom. fast as I can. Craft. Craft. And our armor rating was 370. It's now going to 390. And then, obviously, it's only going to go to, what, 410? When I do this? 410. Hey, but it's better than nothing, right? And at least now I look better because I'm all chitin. I just have to paint this stuff up. We'll be good to go. There we go. Drew in. Okay, you might have noticed in my inventory that I've got some Stargates here. I've been running around, looking for the big alphas, looking for places to put Stargates that are unusual. And one place I came across, as I was turning corners I'd never turned before, and I found a place that I'm going to call, not the underworld, beneath the waterfall. I did not even know that this place existed. So I'm going to take you there and show you this, because it's pretty cool. And hopefully there's nothing bad here, because I'm coming through barefoot, as it were. Yeah. Nothing bad here. Okay. I did not know this place existed on the map. We are at the far western side of the Redwoods, underneath the Redwoods. The waterfall that connects the Redwoods to the snow biome. I never knew that there was actually land down here that you could get on, because there's the land bridge. It's between the waterfall and the land bridge. I did not know you could get down here because I'd never really wanted to find out. I would always avoid falling in. So it never occurred to me that there might be something down here, which is pretty cool, because there's water down here that you can obviously swim in, but there's also sharks. There's a megalodon right there, for instance. So there's a pretty cool water resource. It's pretty deep. You could do a nice base over here, which I thought was pretty cool, where I put the gate. It's fairly flat. Now, things might fall in on you. That's a problem, of course. But it'd give you a really nice little water base, and if you have Stargates, you can put a Stargate underwater and teleport your guy, you know, your water creature, wherever you want to put him. So I thought that was pretty cool. I don't know where else I'm going to put some gates, but this is a pretty neat one. I wanted to put in some ramps real fast. I like to have three ramps across the center on both sides just to make it easier to get up and down, even though I don't think we're going to actually need them in this case because the foundations are not that high up. But anyway, so I think that's going to pretty much wrap us up for this episode, folks. It was kind of a bust on the armor, although we did get some really cool chitin armor, right? Right? And I painted it up. Oh, look at that effect. That's awesome. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time. Bye-bye. There we go.